of our Scope Guest Lecture series, we have with us one of the great personalities. Leadership, brilliance, untiring zest for excellence are the words that comes to our mind when we think about Mr. Alpesh Parekh. He is the man behind one of the successful country clubs in India, Gulmohar Greens Golf and Country Club Limited. It is a beautifully designed country club situated away from the hustle and bustle of city, incorporating all the amenities to serve everyone, from a kid to an oldie. Sir, may I begin the interview? What made you choose golf club as your business? Was golf your passion?
Thank you, first of all, for such an introduction. It's much bigger than what I am, but nevertheless, thank you so much. I decided on golf, not because golf was my passion. When I actually decided to do a golf club, the only golf I knew was the one I used to play on my mobile phone or watch on the TV before going off to sleep, because I always thought when you see green things all around, you get a very beautiful sleep. So that's the only golf I was attached to. But having said on a lighter side, what did happen was that I was always into construction and real estate, was holding on to a decent size of land, not as much as we have right now. And we came to a point in time when we wanted to do something in form of a club, basically, but we're not finding any USP to the project. And that's when, out of the sudden, you get that spark of an idea, and which was golf, which came to me. And I thought that Ahmedabad does not have golf, and we've never had it, because we always thought that golf is a very elite sport, a sport which is only meant either for the oldies or somebody who is very thick-pocketed, needs to have lots of money to do that. And with that seed of a thought, I thought, why couldn't we do a facility where we could bring golf to the city of Ahmedabad and do it in a way which was never ever done before. And with that one little thought in mind, obviously did lots of work behind it, which actually took us, brought us to where we are right now.
What kind of marketing strategies did you use for your business? Like, as golf is not as popular.
As golf or for even for everything else, basically the most important strategy that we followed over the years, and which has worked wonderfully for us, is word of mouth. There cannot be a better strategy than a word of mouth publicity, because that comes from the heart. And when that happens, most of the times you would use that product or that service. It probably goes for you as well. Any shampoo that you could be using, or a cream, or to that matter a restaurant that you might go out to eat, most of the time it's something which is recommended by our friends or family to do that, because they've already tried that, used that, and been there and have found a lot of value proposition in that, and that makes us also to go back to that same place. And that's exactly the strategy we've had so far, that whatever we do, we need to do it very truly and give it back to our client, to our guests, to our members, to an extent that they become the real people who go out in the world and speak about us.
What makes your business initiatives different from your counterparts? What makes them unique and distinct?
A lot of things. While we were working on it, we always realized that there would always be competition, and competition is always good, because it keeps us trying to keep improvising and doing things better, and end of the day, the end user gets the best product. So having said that, with a healthy competition, you also have to have a lot of innovations which needs to be done. And we personally believed, and I personally believe, in something called disruptive innovation. So that's what I would later also be speaking to, if given a chance, with everyone about that in more detail. But that's what we've tried to place ourselves to be more unique in the form, so that we could keep getting more and more members, visitors, guests to come and use our facilities.
Who has been your greatest inspiration?
No doubt, it's my father. He's my greatest inspiration. I've seen him working from the day probably I had my senses. I've seen him working. We come from a very humble family background financially when we started off. So I've seen every walk of life. In fact, while I was in college, I used to go on a rented cycle to study. So having seen that, you know the importance of everything, and having seen my father driving a two-wheeler to a Mercedes Benz, I know that what needs to be done to achieve great heights, and nothing can take away honesty and integrity. So that's the two most important things that I've learned from my father, in addition to hard work. So these three things are the right mix of pill, I would say, every entrepreneur should have to achieve great heights.
How did you decide it on the location of your business, like Ahmedabad?
It was very simple. That was the only land I had. So it was not too much of a thought. We already had a small piece of land, and I have a very interesting story to share on this. When I actually decided to do a golf club, as I said, I actually did not know what's the size of a land is required, how much more do I need to do. And I very confidently started using Google to find out more. And I couldn't find a single golf architect in India who could help me with it. And with a little more research, I came to know that obviously golf comes from Scotland, and yeah. So obviously the Scottish architects have to be the best. And so I found a very good golf architect by the name of Carl Olson. And I still remember back early in 2005 writing a mail to Carl Olson saying that, bluffing basically by saying that I'm an amateur golfer. I hardly knew any golf, but how could I just say I don't know anything? So I said I'm an amateur golfer and I want to set up a golf course, and I have 30,000 square meters of land, and I want to do this, that, you know, so many dreams, aspirations. And having done that, I got a mail back from Mr. Olson, a very sweet mail which I've treasured and still put in my file, in which he very respectfully told me about everything, and in the end said that Alpesh, you've missed out a zero. You probably need 30,000 won't do. You probably need 3 lakh square meters of land to actually set up a facility. So that's exactly when I came to know, oh, I don't have this land. I really need to buy more to really do this project. So however, the space was sort of decided because I had some land bank over there, which was close to Ahmedabad. At that point in time, 10 kilometers, 10 years back, was still a lot of distance. Now it's almost like next door. But at that point in time, it was still away. But I knew that this is still a decent distance where it should not really matter. Having looked at the successes of other clubs like Karnavati and Rajpath, you know that clubs which are a little further away can end up doing well. And with that knowledge on my side, we sort of froze on the land where Gulmohr stands right now.
What are the qualities that you think differentiates an entrepreneur from those who work for others?
There are lots of qualities which actually do differentiate somebody who works for someone else and an entrepreneur. Few of the most important things which come to my mind right this very second are a couple of them. One is the gut feel. Yeah. If you're an entrepreneur, you'll have that instinct, and if that instinct is there, whatever tide can be against you, you can still swim that against the tide and achieve the results. So that's one gut feel an entrepreneur would always have. And the other one is that somebody who's working for someone is always counting 10 to 6. It's just that 8 hours or 10 hours of work time is what he's constantly looking at. Somebody who's working for himself doesn't have a time schedule.
Time
so
bounding.
Yeah, so he probably is not working even 8 hours or 10 hours and might just put in 4 hours if required, or at times is working 7 days a week. So it's that these are the two major differentiators from someone who's working for someone else and when you're working for your own.
What do you believe entrepreneurship is all about?
For me, entrepreneurship is actually showcasing yourself. It's actually a reflection of yourself to the outside world, because every human is an entrepreneur in himself or herself. Whether you work for someone else or you're working for yourself, you always possess that little quality in you which wants you to show your talents, what you are all about, to others. And that's what, in a very simple nutshell, is what entrepreneurship is all about, where you actually get to do that to others. On what scale one ends up doing is a completely a different thing, but to me that's what entrepreneurship is all about, where you could stand up for yourself, for a cause, for a reason, for whatever you believe in, and achieve greater heights on the same.
Any advice for the young people who dream to start their own business?
Sure, I have loads of them. It's always so easy to give free advice when somebody asks for it. So difficult to really follow them. Probably I didn't follow most of them, and I took a lot of time to achieve what I did over a point in time. But my few of my advices to all you young entrepreneurs would be that first and foremost, these are all generic advice and would go to any type of entrepreneurship you end up doing, whether it's a startup, whether it's already ongoing business of your own, your family business, or something completely different where you buy out a company and do something. But the following things actually have no shortcuts to it, and they are integrity. Unless or until you do not have integrity in what you're doing, you will not achieve great heights. Honesty, unless and until you're honest to yourself and to others around you, you would not achieve great heights. And there is no shortcuts to hard work. You have to put in that long hours, those hard work to doing it. You have to be a leader. You can't be a king.
Yeah.
An entrepreneur is a leader who leads a team of people along with him on a journey. He is not a king sitting on a throne and dictating orders, because that no more works. It's generally a leader who will work and do well for his organization. So my advice for all you budding entrepreneurs would be that please follow these three things very closely in whatever you're doing, because a lot of times you'll come across situations where it is so easy to go off the road, so easy to make some money on a very shorthand change. And you may lose the path, because that financial temptation is so much at times that you don't mind doing a little wrong to get that extra financial success. However, it's all short-lived. It never holds on long, because something achieved on doing something wrong is always noticed by others at some point in time, and your credibility would be at stake to a great extent. And once a credibility is damaged, it's very difficult to get that back. So my advice would be to go slow, go steady, and I'm sure it's like a bell curve. One point in time, you'll just shoot up.
Thank you so much, sir. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Likewise. Thank you so much for calling me here. Thank you.